And I saw too that you just raised a bunch of capital. Congratulations in January in a pre-COVID environment. Very awesome. You have some big names. How did you go about raising that round? What were the indicators from the market that you were getting that said, okay, we're in a position now where we're going to scale. We're going to get into every store, or at least try to get into every store in the United States.
Sure thing. So 2020 was definitely a very pivotal year for our business. We started the year in about 350 stores. I was the only full-time employee, and we had big plans for the year. We knew that we were going into Target in a big way and that we were going to go into Sprouts and expand with Whole Foods. And then George Floyd got murdered, and there was this newfound desire from businesses and investors and influencers to amplify Black-owned businesses that gave our business a lift like I could have never imagined. And so we right now, in March of 2021, we're in about 6,000 stores. Our team is 7 people. We're doubling that over the next couple of months. And so we're in major growth mode. And so I think it was the growth that we had over the past year that really got investors interested. And, you know, I didn't plan to raise a Series A until maybe this summer, this fall, but there was a lot of inbound interest. And so I figured, you know, we should take advantage of the momentum while we have it so that we can go ahead and go into the new year ready to execute against our lofty goals. And thankfully, because we had that momentum, I got to be very selective about the partners that we work with. And so over 50% of our cap table is Black and Brown investors, which was very intentional. I think all of our investors are very mission aligned with our business, understand the importance of causes like increasing diversity in the natural foods industry, working to eradicate childhood food insecurity, and are very supportive in my mission to drive those things as we grow our business.
That's amazing. Kudos to you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's exciting. We do real estate development here, and my goal for every project, so if I enter a Latino neighborhood, let's say, then I try to get to, you know, investors that are Latino because it means a little bit more to them. And to me, it's like, that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for, it's a deeper connection. If you're just money, yeah, it's okay. But, you know, we're looking for more of like social capital. Like, I like knowing maybe you went to high school here. Maybe you know the fire chief or whatever it might be. But that personal connection to sort of your heritage, I think, is important when you're investing, or at least in what we do, which is investing in a lot of these communities to build something and create some jobs that help at the end of the day and impact several thousands of people.
I agree. Awesome. I think anything that you can do to create generational wealth in your community is like, it's more that undue pressure and the responsibility and something I welcome, but that I think a lot about.
Do you have a dream investor, like someone who's on your list that you'd love to have on in your next round?
I think we have them. We literally, like John Foraker, who scaled Annie's and ran General Mills natural and organic business, Jay-Z through Marcy Venture Partners, Rihanna. Like, I couldn't ask for a more dreamless group of investors, you know, from a high profile perspective, but more from a like mission alignment perspective. Sure. And belief in our business.
Did that surprise you? So we've talked to some people that have had like the likes of Kobe Bryant who passed, but on, and the question I always have is like, does it surprise you that, because everyone knows them in a certain way, right? Everyone knows the celebrity in a certain light. And not everyone knows like that person only invests in vegan-based startups. And I think it's hard for people to connect the dots. And so as you were meeting some of them and taking these investor meetings, were you surprised by just their level of knowledge in spaces that maybe at the beginning you wouldn't have thought they, you know, they'd know much about?
I think I was just most pleasantly surprised by how mission aligned everyone was, how they cared a lot about the HBCU fellowship program, the work we do around childhood food insecurity, how dedicated we are to making a safe and high quality product, and not necessarily like the fancy fluffy metrics. They actually cared about like building a sustainable business that was going to hopefully try to make a positive impact in the world.
I think that's it. Yeah, that's awesome. I think like we invest in some companies and everyone asks me like, oh, what's the thing you look for? And I'm like, honestly, their dedication to the problem they're solving. Like, I don't care, you know, if they're making money or they're not there yet. It's really just based on where is this person going? What really wakes them up in the morning? And do I think they're the best in the game? Because at some point, if there's two equal people and one person is solving a problem that's personal to them, they're going to win eventually over time. Even if they have no business acumen or even never went to college, like they're going to win because they're going to figure it out because they have the, like, energy creates discipline and they have the internal energy to want that. And so they will at the end of the day succeed. And it sounds so frou-frou. Like people are like, that's it. There's no like Excel sheet. There's no like MRR or like the run rate or like the recurring revenue. I'm like, no, it's none of that. It's, is this problem really personal to the individual? And are they building things around them that are in line with their mission? And if not, it's pretty obvious actually when it's not, you know, that's my take on it. And so it sounds like you're in the same boat.
Definitely so. And you could feel it in the conversations, because I feel like the investors that we clicked most with were trying to understand what drove me and like who I was as a person and what my values were and what type of company, like what type of leader I would be. And then there were these very like transactional investors who were kind of like, well, tell me why your margin went up 1 point this month and then down the next point. And it's just like, we're not aligned. And like, don't get me wrong, I know the margin and it's important, right? But like finding somebody that you're mission aligned with and really believes in you and what you're doing, I think is the most important thing.
Yeah, it's like, do you think you can find a cheaper sugar alternative?
Right, exactly.
To drop, to increase margin by a penny. What would that do? And you're like, okay, wrong guy. Sorry, gotta go. Yep.